नमस्कार दोस्तों, स्वागत है आप सभी का स्टडी आईक्यू में। मैं हूं आपका दोस्त राहुल सायगांवकर और आज हम लोग तेलंगाना से जुड़ी हुई खबर के बारे में चर्चा करने वाले हैं। आप यहां पर देख सकते हो तेलंगाना विलेज हैज बीन सेलेक्टेड एज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट टूरिज्म विलेजेस बाय यूनाइटेड नेशंस। तो हम लोग इस लेक्चर में समझेंगे तेलंगाना के उस विलेज के बारे में जिसको वन ऑफ द बेस्ट टूरिज्म विलेजेस घोषित किया गया है। इसमें जानेंगे कौन सा वो गांव है, कौन सी यूनाइटेड नेशंस की एजेंसी है जिसने डिक्लेयर किया है। ये रहेगा एजेंडा हमारे डिस्कशन का और दिस डिस्कशन इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस इन इंग्लिश। एज आई मेंशन द तेलंगाना विलेज हैज बीन सेलेक्टेड एज वन ऑफ द बेस्ट टूरिज्म विलेजेस। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दैट। टू गेट दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन बी विद मी ऑन स्टडी आई क्यू एंड इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर स्टेट पीएससी एग्जामिनेशंस, हियर इज अ लिस्ट ऑफ द स्टेट पीएससी कोर्सेज दैट वी रन एंड डू रिमेंबर वी हैव अ तेलंगाना पीएससी कोर्स ऑल्सो। इफ यू वॉन्ट मोर डिटेल्स जस्ट विजिट studyiq.com और डाउनलोड आर ऐप फ्रॉम गूगल प्ले स्टोर टू नो मोर अबाउट अस। राइट, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट Telangana's Pochampalli village. Which village has been selected? Telangana's Pochampalli has been declared as one of the finest tourism villages by United Nations body. Which UN body has announced it? It's the UNWTO. Please remember, it's not World Trade Organization. It's World Tourism Organization, which is United Nations specialized agency, which works towards sustainable tourism. One of the prime agendas of UNWTO is to achieve these sustainable development goals. Everybody knows that tourism is a very, very big sector which helps the livelihoods of millions of people. And UNWTO works towards responsible, sustainable and universally accessible tourism. Now, let's talk about this UNWTO in short before we swoop into the village which has been selected, that is Pochampalli. UNWTO was set up in 1975. 1st November 1975, UNWTO came into being. It is an intergovernmental organization where the membership is of about 159 member states, 6 associate members and many observers also. There are more than 500 affiliate members where different NGOs, intergovernmental organizations, non-governmental organizations, they are also members of UNWTO. Its main body is the General Assembly, which is the supreme organization of UNWTO. It takes all the decisions of UNWTO. Please remember that the UN World Tourism Organization's headquarters is at Madrid in Spain. As I told you, it works towards sustainable and universally accessible tourism for all. This year in 2021, UNWTO have started a pilot initiative known as the Best Tourism Villages. You can see the tweet here, the recent tweet by UN World Tourism Organization, where they have said in less than 2 weeks, we'll announce best tourism villages in the world. 75 countries had sent applications of 174 villages. From India, we had also sent application and one of that village was Pochampalli. Although officially, the World Tourism Organization has not announced the victors, but they have communicated to the respective governments. And you can see here a tweet by V. Srinivas Gowd, where he held a press meet and said that Pochampalli village of Telangana has been selected as one of the best tourism villages in the world. Let's talk about this particular pilot initiative. What is the objective of this program? As I told you, this is the first time that United Nations WTO is running this Tourism Village Initiative. The objective of this initiative is to highlight those villages which preserve culture, which preserve the tradition, which celebrate diversity and try to protect their biodiversity also. As I told you, UNWTO works towards sustainable tourism. Their objectives are threefold, where they want to contribute towards people's livelihoods. You see here, reducing inequalities, for enhancing the rural incomes. They want to bring prosperity, transforming the rural areas, and they also work towards the welfare of the planet, that is protecting the biodiversity. Now this year in May 2021, the process of best tourism villages began by the UNWTO. You can see here the launch was on May 26, 2021. Now the deadline for the countries to send their applications was 15th September, and we did send our applications also. And the advisory board, which was set up by the General Assembly of UNWTO itself, they went for a selection process and they have selected a list of villages which are finest in the world in terms of tourism. And one of that is Pochampalli. The formal announcement will come very soon when the 24th General Assembly of UNWTO will take place, and it is going to take place from 30th November to 3rd December in Madrid in Spain. So we'll wait officially, we'll keep an eye on that assembly also. Whenever it happens, we'll talk about that assembly and we'll talk about the different villages and the speciality also. But as of now, we do know that we sent some applications. By September 15th, we sent application for 3 villages from India. First village was Madhya Pradesh, Ladpura Khas village. Another village from Meghalaya, Khonthong village. Khonthong village is also known as the Whistling village. And the third entry was Telangana's Pochampalli, which has become victorious. But do let me know if anybody who's watching from Madhya Pradesh, especially from Ladpura Khas village and Meghalaya's Khonthong village, do comment in our comment section and let us know what is the speciality of these villages. I told you about Meghalaya's Whistling village, that is the Khonthong village. But do let us know what is important about these. And if you are an aspirant of UPSC Civil Services or any other examination, do research and let me know in the comment section about these villages, because it's not just Pochampalli, because we are going to talk about Pochampalli in this video. But do let me know about the other villages also. Now, as I told you, the UNWTO has announced that Pochampalli has been selected one of the finest villages. The question for you is, have you ever heard of Pochampalli village? I'm quite sure you must have heard, especially if you are an aspirant of UPSC Civil Services or State PSC examination, you must have heard about Pochampalli. Pochampalli is a small town which is about 50 kilometers from Hyderabad. Earlier, it was in the Nalagonda district, but right now it is in the Yadadri Bhuvanagiri district in Telangana. Now, I'm quite sure if you're an aspirant, you must have heard of Pochampalli, because Pochampalli is known for its Ikat silk saris. Ikat silk saris are very beautiful saris from South India, from Telangana. You must have seen them, because it also has a geographical indication. It has got a GI tag way back in 2004 itself. So you must have heard about that. But a very important thing about Pochampalli is that it is very much connected to the Bhudan movement. A very important story is there from Pochampalli. In fact, if you ask me about Bhudan movement, we talk about Bhudan and we remember Vinoba Bhave. After Bhudan, the Gramdan movement came. But what is the story behind this Bhudan movement? Where was it conceptualized? The initial idea, it came from Pochampalli. In fact, Pochampalli itself is known as Bhudan Pochampalli village. Why did that happen? See, there's a story behind it. Vinoba Bhave, who was the pioneer of this Bhudan movement, he visited, or he was invited to Pochampalli. He stayed there overnight, and the next morning, some villagers came to Vinoba Bhave asking for help. 40 families asked for 40 acres of land. They said that we want land for our own livelihood. I'm repeating, 40 families came to Vinoba Bhave and asked help, that from government, please get us 40 acres of land which will help these 40 families. So Vinoba Bhave thought that if the government is not able to provide, he simply raised a question in front of the Gram Sabha. He asked that, is there anyone who can help these 40 families by providing them 40 acres of land? And it was then one of the zamindars, V. Ramachandra Reddy, who stood up, who raised his hand, and he said that, I will give these people 1,000 acres of land. It was here that the idea of Bhudan was conceptualized. Vinoba Bhave thought, if this can happen in one village, why can't we spread this to other villages? And from here, a revolutionary movement began, Bhudan movement, and it spread to many villages, predominantly in South India and in many parts of North India also. Bhudan ultimately transformed into Gramdan. We know about these movement because it was one of the important land reforms in India. So now you know. Have you heard of Pochampalli? Obviously, yes. Pochampalli, for Pochampalli Ikat Saris. Pochampalli for the Bhudan movement. In fact, the name of Pochampalli is Bhudan Pochampalli movement itself. And now you will know that it is also the first village from India to get the World Tourism Award by United Nations World Tourism Organization. Very soon, it will get it at the General Assembly in Madrid in Spain. We'll wait and watch for that. That is it in this particular lecture. And I hope you liked the video. If you did, do follow me on @RahulSai222ID. My Facebook, Instagram and Telegram channel ID are same. If you have any doubts, if you have any queries, if you want to connect with me, you can anytime message me on Instagram. I do reply on weekends. Thank you for watching this video. Jai Hind.